As we begin our section, we'll pray and begin. By the time I believe all our friends will be joined. Let's pray. Most gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you, Master, for the time that you've given us. We humbly surrender our hearts and minds unto thy feet in this time. Dear Lord, we pray you may bless us and be with us. Lord, in this evening, as we discuss some of the things related with research methodology, Lord, we pray you may give us the wisdom from above, as you being the source of all knowledge, fill our hearts with your discernment. Help us, O Lord, that we may communicate to each other and make things understand, Lord. Help us, bless us and be with us, Lord. Thank you, Master, for Immortal and Biblical Seminary. Bless them, Lord. Bless all their activities. We thank you, Master, for the family. We thank you for all the students. Bless each and everyone. Continue to be with us and help us, Lord. Thank you, Master, for hearing and answering your prayer. In the most precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we offer this prayer. Amen. I'm really glad knowing each of you. Indeed, a great joy to see all your faces. Knowing your commitment to the Lord, your love towards the Lord, and your passion to serve Him truly interests me. I'm really glad that you are committed. You're committed to serve the Lord. All of your hearts are true to the Lord, and I'm really glad about it. I pray that may God bless all of you, all your ministries, your life, your families. May He use all of you for His kingdom's expansion. God bless you. We have only a very little time, as for me. But I am very glad all of you can understand English very well, I believe. Because you are very fluent in introducing yourself. So my halfway through is done. I was a bit tense whether you will be able to follow me or not. That was one major concern I had. But I'm happy that you can understand my language, because for me to shift between languages is also very difficult. Once I start in English, then I can't actually move to Malayalam. But if you ask me to stop and then tell it in Malayalam, I can. Otherwise, I cannot be in Malayalam. So, but you can ask me if you don't follow me. I prefer better English itself as we move on in learning. When you have doubt, confusion, you can ask me. In one way, what we are dealing is one of the easiest subjects. But on the other side, this is also one of the difficult part for some. So I don't know how you will be taking this one. Either you will feel it as a tough call or easy. It depends on you. And for me, I am actually a teacher of New Testament, and I love to teach New Testament than any other thing. But research methodology is the course that is given to me, so I cannot say no. But I am to say, in connection with my researches, my work, my writings, I have enough experience to tell you concerning this research writing. As being a student as well as being a teacher, because for last more than 12 years, I am guiding MTA students. And for last 4 years that I am guiding PhD students. I have done my doctorate, my work. By the time I almost memorized all the rules and regulations related with research methodology. Handling so many diseases in connection with my writings too, all academic writings that I have done is also following this methodology. So more than just a textbook learning, you can make this time as a practical learning. So if you have something in your mind that I must talk, then you must ask me. I have something already prepared, the PowerPoint is there, I will deal with it. But by the time we move to each topic, if you have some doubt, if you have something that personally in your mind you had how to handle this, then you can ask me and I will be dealing with that. So here, research methodology is our focus, but you know you are now in the ministry. Everything that we do is in connection with theological education. Otherwise, you would have not been in this forum now. Actually, sometimes I used to feel what we find there outside, some of the writings that we have different types of writings, different types of writings. Some of the things we have, now we have even in WhatsApp, we have writings. Some people are writing different articles in the WhatsApp. Or we have magazines, monthly, you know, magazines that we get, we have people writing their articles. Maybe some of you are also good writers. Or in your college days, in your secular learning, you might have done writing. So those things we are not dealing here. We are dealing here only related with your research that you may do a thesis in your final year of MPH, final year of MD, or from the second year of your doctorate, you will begin working on with the research. The major focus is thesis writing. But I am also interested to not just deal with this disease alone, but there are a few more things I would like to talk about. In the section A, I would like to deal with common study plan, timetable, time management, discipline, types of assignments that we usually write, step to write thesis, and the major contents of thesis proposal. So we'll be dealing with these aspects, and in these actually first two are common, nothing to do with research methodology, but I insist on study plan before you begin anything. Either you are an MD student or MPH or PhD, all together at least for a semester or for a course, you must have a study plan. Maybe thesis is something that we do at the end. When you begin your theological education, you must have a study plan. This study plan, how you prepare, suppose you have in one semester, if you are an MD student, you have 6 courses in a semester. When you get the syllabus itself, you need to divide the syllabus for yourself. You may have the teacher teaching, no matter. But when you get the syllabus, you have to divide the syllabus according to the time permitted for that course. If it is 6 subjects and 6 months, so you get at least 30 days for one course. You divide the 30 days in 6 months. And then out of these 30 days, how you will make your study? You may have your assignments. You may have some works related to your paper. Some notes you have to prepare, some readings you may have to do. For all these 30 days, you must divide the whole syllabus and the timing. That is related with the course semester study plan. Or if you are doing a thesis, because that is our major focus, I would like to talk about that. You know your course of study. For MBA students, you will get 1 year to do your thesis. Normally second year. For a doctoral student, you will get 2 years minimum. If you have some assessment papers in the first year, second and third year is actually for your thesis. So you will get minimum 2 years. As I said, I have also done these things. I practice it. That is why I'm saying this is one of the best methods to deal with your study. So when we begin our work, suppose your thesis, you started working with your thesis. Then you know the year, the call time, maybe 1 year or 2 years, depends. I put it as 1 year. So you get 10 months to work your thesis. And you know your thesis may have 4 or 5 chapters, which means after 10 months, 2 months are for one chapter. If you manage this time properly, you will surely be able to complete your calls on due time. Otherwise, you will not be able to finish in 2 years or 3 years. When I began my studies, when I did my doctorate, 1 year was assessment papers, 4 assessment papers. 1 assessment is equal to 1 MPH thesis. So 4 assessments in the first year, and then by second year when I started, I managed my studies, and then because of that, in 1 year I completed my doctoral work. I completed my doctorate thesis in 1 year. We were the first students in FFRR to submitted the thesis in 3 years. So for you, if you plan your study, if you set your time properly, surely you will be able to complete it on time. So please manage your study plan and manage your timing. As I said, study plan and timetable, time management are same. It's a discipline. Time management is literally, or study plan is a discipline. We ask our children to follow a timetable. Why? We tell them, we write from morning 6 o'clock to night 10 o'clock. You do this, you do that, you do this in this time. Why? Because we know the value of time. So now, not for daily basis, but for a month, for a semester, or for a year, you need to prepare a study plan. You need to manage your whole year with that. Now, when we look at types of assignments, you have different types of assignments. You may have reading reports. Some teachers will give you reading report. Reading the full syllabus. We used to actually do reading report even when the teachers are not demanding. Even when the teachers are not requiring us to do a reading report, we used to do reading report. You know why? It is only through reading you understand things. In school days, we have learned that even for the whole life, learning 25% only the teachers can teach. And then 25% is from home. That's the first stage. 25% from the teachers. 25% from our friends. And the last 25% we learn through the ages. Life experience. That is related to the whole life. If it's so, one course in one semester, 2 days or 4 days of classes, do you think you will learn the whole syllabus? It's not possible. It's not possible. So there will be selected bibliography given for you, and you must surely do readings related to your course, and you must prepare a reading report. You must separate each file for each course, either in the form of notebook or as file system you can keep. By A4 size paper, and then write down one subject, a set note, you file it. Some material will be given from the college. Use that also, spiral it and keep it. So each subject, you must have enough reading reports. And then, while you read, remember, when you are reading for reading report, 10:1, which means when you read 10 pages, you only need to write down one page of report, 10:1. When you read 100 pages, you may have 10 pages of report. So for each course, at least read 300 pages. Read 300 pages. So you will have 30 pages of report. Whenever you read, this is also just for your knowledge, whenever you read, in the beginning of that page itself, please write down the author name, book name, and the page number that you are reading. Author name, book name, and the page number you are reading, you must write it. And secondly, reading report may be asked by the teacher to write and submit it. Maybe from selected words or from one book. Maybe one book is given and the teacher is asking you to read and write the reading report. Same method is followed. For 10 pages, one page of reading report. For 100 pages, 10 pages of reading report. These are methodological. Some teachers may say, read the book and write 25 pages. Or read the book and write 3 pages. Read the book and write 15 pages. Depends on the teacher. But the basic scientific methodology for reading report is, read 10 pages, write one page of notes. Then book review. Book review, when you do book review, I don't know whether you have an assignment given like that for book review. Even for doctoral students, we ask them to do book review because some of the direct books will be there and you may have to read them. If you have not seen book reviews, you can also Google it to just type and see how to do a book review or the models for book review you will get it. When you deal with book review, three things. One, in the introductory part, you have to say about the whole book, author, title, number of pages, publication, other details you must give it in the introduction. The second paragraph must be, it can be one page, book review can be one page, till three pages you can go. The second part of your book review must be the content of the book. What is dealt within the book as it is. As it is, you have to deal. What is the topic? What are the areas the author has covered? Which are the major methodology adopted? What is the major focus of the book? All these you can deal in the second paragraph. Third paragraph or third section must be your review. How much you like the book? Whether the author was faithful to the title, whether the author was right with outline, whether the outline has dealt detailed in the text itself. And your suggestion, recommendation, whether you recommend it and to whom you recommend it. I recommend it to the theological students, I recommend it to the lay people, I recommend it to the common readers, depends on you. So you have to choose the recommendation based on the content. If it is academic book, then suggest it to the academic level. If it is for the devotional, then recommend it to the church. If it is for students, then do that. So book review must have these three contents. Then you have paper presentation. Especially for doctoral students, I believe there are paper presentations. And MBA students, we always used to say, only the final year students must present the paper. If it is MD, only final year students. Final year, final semester. Only the last semester is permitted for MBA students to write and present a paper. For MBA students, we ask them to do it in the second year, paper presentation. And for the doctoral students, second and third years, they can do the paper presentation. If you ask me why, it is because only then they learn, how to perform with the paper presentation. That's all. Otherwise, there is no hard and fast rule on it. We want the teachers to teach. In some colleges, if you go, you may find, especially in MBA classes, the teachers may not teach anything. They will just come to the class, divide the syllabus, give to the students as paper presentation. And it goes on with that. And we used to say, the level of student may be as MTS, but the teacher is PhD. If only the teacher provides enough knowledge to these MTS students, they can grow. If you ask the students only to work out, then they may not grow to the expected level of an MTS or PhD. So we want the seminars to be conducted for the students. Now, class presentation is this. Then we have college presentation. Sometimes you may have an open forum like this, and then you are asked to present a paper. That practice also must be maintained. In regular colleges, we used to maintain that all the students, MD final years, MPH and PhD candidates will be attending this open college seminar. Where the student is preparing a topic, writing a paper, and then presenting, writing down the detailed presentation, presenting it either with the help of PowerPoint or without PowerPoint. They present their paper and there will be open forum for the students to ask questions or faculty members to ask a question, clarify it, and then the moderator concludes the section. In the national and international seminars also, the same method is followed. There will be a moderator, a topic will be given. In some of these presentations that we used to have, the publication will be there later on. Maybe 4 to 7 people will be presenting the paper. All these papers will be edited later and published on. There are many writings like that. Books are available like that. International seminars also similar as this. Topics will be given based on one particular topic. Then there will be presentation from different departments, and then all those papers will be edited together and published as a book. Beginning actually that also like a class presentation. Then we have 10 papers. 10 papers are like short theses, or shorter than an assessment. Assessment paper is like a short thesis. A 10 paper is shorter than an assessment. When it goes to higher end degree, maybe 10 paper is given to BTech final year students. They don't have a thesis. So we ask them to do a 10 paper. 10 paper, one particular topic, based on that they write the whole thing. No chapter division in 10 paper, no chapter division in assessment also. Assessment is actually a preparation for thesis writing. If we have four assessment papers related to our thesis, that can be four chapters of our thesis. I don't know whether you have given any thesis, any assessment paper or not, that I do not know. But in our colleges, we have doctoral students. In the first year, sometimes 1.5 years, they will be doing these assessment papers. Nearly four assessment papers will be given, sometimes two, sometimes three, depends on the guide. So 2 to 4 assessment papers will be given for the doctoral students. It can be a topic like thesis. For example, ecological systems of the present day and its influence upon the children. It can be an assessment topic. So, but it can also reflect like a thesis. So assessment paper is a shorter form of thesis, and term paper is shorter form of assessment paper. Either we write paper presentation, term paper, assessment paper or thesis, we must have enough footnotes and bibliography. For term paper, paper presentation, term paper, assessment and thesis. In book review, we will have only one book name, that we will give it in the introduction itself. So no other bibliography. After the writing, and so you can give at the end also, you can give the bibliography, but same book. But in paper presentation, suppose you are writing 6 pages, you must use at least 6 books. If you are writing a term paper 25 pages, then you must have 25 books. MDiv thesis 60 pages, so there should be 60 books. MGIS thesis 120 pages, so there should be 120 books. PhD thesis 300 pages, so there should be 300 books. I generalize as books, I will define what we mean by these books. It's not just book as we say, it can include commentaries, dictionaries, books, articles, bibliography, or other published, non-published material. But I just put it the common word books. You must have 120 material for MGH, 120 books or material for MGH, and 300 books for your doctoral dissertation.
Sorry, how many books for the MDiv for thesis?
60.
60, okay.
Because we write 60 pages. So how many pages you are writing depends on that. You must have books. If you are writing a paper 6 pages, then minimum. It's minimum. Sometimes we used to have 25, 30, 40 books when we write maybe 10 pages. Some of our articles, some of our writings, if you look at, you can find sometimes footnote goes up to 105, and the bibliography, that may be 40, 50 bibliography. Depends on the quality of work. I am saying the minimum work, minimum. If you are working on for 10 pages, at least you must read 10 to 50 books. Only then you get full understanding of that particular area or topic. So read as maximum, as I said in the beginning. Now this is actually a shift directly to the thesis. We will deal with it, again, yet another process. But this is the process. In section A, actually, I'm dealing directly with all these, covering all that you do in connection with your theological education. So, steps to write thesis.
The first thing, madam.
Yes.
Excuse me, ma'am. We get a time to ask our doubts. We get, because I have few doubts to ask. Should I interrupt or after you finish your talk?
I can finish section A and then give you maybe some time. We'll discuss.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. After finishing this, steps to write thesis, then we have a break. So, steps to write thesis. So, when you are writing thesis, all of you are writing thesis, either in MD, MDH, or in PhD. So, not all these things detailed. Number one, when you deal with, I go this path, these are actually, each section must be taken in a day. But now we are not dealing that detailly. I'm just summarizing only all what we need to know. You just go through these things that we have, and then whichever area you ask me, I give you further discussion on the same. Okay. Some of these areas may not be interested. Some areas maybe you really want to know. And those areas we will deal with. Today itself we will deal those things. Okay. So first thing, suppose now you are in your MTH or your PhD program. You must first of all have your area specialized. You must know which department you are in, and then write your thesis only from your department. Do not write thesis from other department. If you are a pastoral care and counseling student, then write only from there. But for MD, no such choices. But even in MD, you can do it. Suppose while you study MD itself, you know you like to go for either mission, you like to go for New Testament or Old Testament or history or theology, mission. Any department you would like to go, try choosing the same area for your MD thesis. MD students, already you are in a particular department. Take topic only from there. PhD students, the same thing. Area specialization is very important. Which area you are opting. Even for PhD, suppose you are already involved with children, write something related to children. If you are already involved yourself with some of the social activities, deal with that. If you are already in ministry and mission among Muslims or with some other religious group, human trafficking or other issues, if you know something very personally, then deal with those topics. So area specialization is very important. That must be our core interest. Every time that passion within us will pull us into that which is work. If we are fully involved into it, if we are writing something which are not at all interested for our soul, then we will not push on with that. Somehow I want to finish and throw it off. That will be the attitude. It should not be. Your body, soul, spirit must be there in your thesis. Some people used to join their studies and then ask somebody else to write the thesis and finish it off. I know about those things, but I'm not talking about that. Even if you're writing just 3 pages, may your heart be there. If you're writing a thesis, the same thing. Only then, you know, we used to say work is worship. The same with the writing. Sometimes I used to feel these writers, those who write continually, those who publish continually, we used to say either publish or perish. So if you are either publishing or our ideas are dying off. So, but those writers, those who are writing continually, their life is like a tapasya. It's like a very great devotion that they spend. Sometimes to prepare a paper, sometimes to prepare for some seminars, we may have to spend more than, maybe 1 month. 1 month, when I say in your calculation, the day maybe like 30 days, if I say for you 15 day time. No, that's not true. There are times the writer sleeps maybe 1 hour. Thoughts will not allow them to sleep. Maybe 2 hours, maybe 4 hours. It's a practice, a constant practice that will make you some or other day a very strong writer. And then when we deal with these timings, writings, all these things, as I said, area specialization number one, and then your reading. Reading for 2 reasons. One, reading to know that particular subject. Reading, anything it can be. Suppose you want to know about your topic, what was Jesus' attitude towards children? Or you want to know what was Paul's standing related to slavery? Then read. Read related to it, but don't stop there. Once you read, you understand things, and then your mind started thinking new ways. Write down those things also. From readings, you get half part of your work. By reading, you develop half part. Your thoughts must be, motivated while you read. When you read something, there must be some kind of passion within you that makes you think that makes you work out things, and then you will find that your thoughts are being developed. Then, so continue reading, always read. Then you need to collect bibliography, bibliography collection. That is also very important. When you start writing your thesis, you must know, before writing the thesis itself, you must know whether I'll be able to collect required number of books. If you are an MDA student, before you jump into the work, look for bibliography. At least before beginning your work, you must find 80 books. Because altogether you need 120 books. But if you find 80 to 100 books before you begin your work, then your work is halfway done. If you are not finding, many students have discontinued their thesis because they were not able to find their material. They will say, when they bring the thesis proposal title, we will say, you may not find the material. Then they will say, no, we will find, we have material, we have seen. And then they start writing, they stop in between because they will not be able to find enough bibliography for them. So find your own bibliography before you begin your work. Then you must also have thoughts in formation. When you write a thesis, there must be some ideas in your mind, which we call it scientifically hypothesis. But those ideas must be strong enough in your mind before you begin your work. Before you begin writing, those thoughts must be summarized. So you need to find the area, read related to that particular area, collect bibliography related to that area. Then you must develop a thought. When you develop that thought, please write down. Please write down. We used to say sometimes the thoughts are like, you know, thunder and lightning. It comes and goes. If you don't record, you will never ever again that thought again in your life. So when a new thought strikes your mind, please note down. Sometimes nobody might have thought in that way. Your experience, your life, your view towards life, your surrounding, all these are actually forming your thoughts. So you must write down whenever some new thought struck you, especially related to your thesis. Write down everything together. And then once this thought is formed, write the proposal summary. Don't write the title, don't write the proposal first, but write down the summary of your proposal, what you're going to do. What is coming to your mind that you must do, that you need to write down first. Then form the title. Based on the title, prepare the thesis proposal. So, first of all, spend your time in finding out your area. In your department itself, suppose if you are doing mission, then you have to look at whether history of the mission, or if you are a history student, look at what is early church, middle age, or modern period. If you are pastoral care and counseling, then you need to deal with one particular people group, either child or adolescent, early adolescents, or middle or later, or you have to look at marital life, or whatever may be. You need to first specialize your area. After specializing, read related to it, collect bibliography, form your thought, write down proposal summary, then form the title, then prepare the thesis proposal. Now, how to prepare, what are the contents should be there in the proposal? These are actually the stages at which you may have to do with the thesis while you are making thesis proposal ready. Process of making a thesis proposal. You have to look at making up the thesis proposal, that the details are coming up, but these things you must keep it in mind. You need to have the process of making thesis proposal, the details of proposal I will tell, but make your bibliography ready, collect the material, arrange the material for each chapter, read, comprehend all those things. Then make out ideas, reflect on, write or type those ideas, edit, re-edit it, ask somebody to read it for you, listen, correct the languages, look for methodology corrections, prepare each chapter, then make the final thesis. this is while you are working with your chapter, working with your proposal. Starting, we said, while preparing your thesis proposal or while preparing for your research, this is in the process of time. First, you will be making your thesis proposal ready, and then that we have already said how to come to that thesis proposal. Then already you have collected some bibliography that you arranged it. Then you may have to go to some libraries and collect all those materials. Collect material as maximum. Nowadays we have different models for collecting material. Either you can xerox it, you can scan it, you can take photos, you can read and record it and then listen it later on. Or you can download it as PDF files from the internet or purchase books. Collecting material in different ways. And then once you have this material collected, for example, especially doctoral students, you have 300 books already xeroxed, for example. You don't know what to do with it. Take each book, see the content, separate it for each chapter. Which means, suppose you have 100 books, divide it as 3 or 4 sections for each chapter, set it separately for each chapter. Or read the material, write in the file, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, which chapter you are going to use this material. According to that, you need to set in your table, for each chapter, you have to separate the material and keep it. Then read, you are doing first chapter, read related to it. Take the first set of material that you collected for chapter 1, read. Then comprehend the idea. Make out the ideas, the process of writing thesis. Then you need to reflect on. Either you can use the paper and pen to write down or else you can type in the computer. It has its own benefits and demerits. When you write with hands, you are more closer to the work. When you type it, easy for you to cut and paste. You can change the sentence position. But while writing, you cannot do that. But you're more close towards the paper. You can scribble it in the side. You can write there for the next chapter in the side. Those things you can do it in typing. So either you are writing or typing depends on your present state. Suppose you are very fluent, very, trained so well in computer, then type it. But if you are good in writing, write. Depends on most of the writers, they write in paper and ink and then they type it. The final one that I did. Read it, edit it. Sometimes you can ask your family members to read it. Sometimes you can correct very well when you listen than when you read. Ask somebody in the family, either children or husband or wife or someone who can read, tell them to read it. You listen to it so that you can correct the grammar, you can correct the thoughts, you can correct the whole idea, system, everything. So read, listen, edit. And we also have mobile or computer application that will read the text for us. So you can listen to those and then correct it. Correct the language as well as the methodology. Finish each chapter. Do not drag here and there. Suppose you are doing it in computer, you got the material for the third chapter, first time down, no problem. But do not start working in third chapter. First you finish first chapter, then go for second, then go for third, then go for fourth. Do not work here and there. There must be concentration to one chapter and work and finish it off. Do not work hand in hand to all the chapters. You can add the material and keep the file, no problem. But do not work between the chapters. Work each chapter, finish each chapter, then finally finish the whole thesis. Now coming to the formation of thesis proposal. This also we have other segments. If we have some doubt, I can deal with those things. Otherwise, we will look at these things as it is. In a thesis proposal, when you are writing a thesis proposal, all what I mentioned here must be there, especially for a doctoral thesis proposal. When you are writing dissertation, when you are writing a doctoral thesis, you must have all these things. For MD, maybe 1 or 2 points can be avoided. Or for MD, some of these things can be avoided. I will tell you what can be avoided. In every proposal, there must be title. Title cannot be avoided. Title is the major focus of your work. In other words, it must summarize the whole thesis. title must contain the following things. At least there will be four segments in the title. For example, conflict resolution and kingdom value, a study on Lucan parables, a socio-narrative analysis. You know, there are four aspects. Number one, chapter one, socio-narrative analysis. Number two, Lucan parables. Number three, conflict in Lucan parables. Number four, conflict resolution in Lucan parables. Next, you can give the indication. So, same way, you must have all your theses summarized in one statement or one sentence or smaller than a sentence. That is a title. The whole thesis, you know, when you hear the title itself, you must get the, you know, taste of your work. Ecological concerns of Jesus, a study of Mark and parables. So what all you have to study? Mark's gospel, Mark and parables, ecological concern of Jesus and its implication. So same like that, when you say a topic, that topic must cover your methodology, your area of specialization, what you think as unique and its implication. So that is title. The second thing is the statement of the problem. Every thesis must have a problem. It's not in a negative sense. There's problem which literally means an area to study. An area to study. So you must have a statement of the problem. Some colleges will allow only one sentence, one statement, because it is statement of the problem. Some colleges will permit you to write one paragraph, but not more than a paragraph. Never write more than a paragraph for the statement of the problem. Maximum content you can give is a paragraph for the statement of the problem. Now, what is the statement of the problem? Statement of the problem is the explanation to the title. So what you say in the title is a bit more explained in the statement of the problem. Now, elaboration of the problem. Elaboration of the problem for MTS, it can be maximum 2 pages. And for maybe doctorate, it can go up to 4 pages, elaboration of the problem. For MD, it can be 1 page, elaboration of the problem. 1, 2, 4. 1 for MD, 2 for MDS, 4 for PhD. Elaboration of the problem is the elaboration of the statement of the problem. What you said as one statement or one paragraph in the statement of the problem must be explained in the elaboration of the problem. Every aspect of your thesis must be dealt in the elaboration of the problem. And the next one is the hypothesis. Hypothesis is the focus of your work, that you have comprehended something. For example, as I said, conflict resolution, study of Lucan parables, then you have already conceived in your mind that there is some kind of conflict resolution, and you are trying to prove in the work that it is there. Hypothesis can be proven or disproved. That is not a problem. It depends on your work. Something is already established, but you want to disprove it, you can do it. Hypothesis is the thesis, or you hypothetically think that this is the major focus, and you work it related to it. It can be proven or disproved, no problem. Then objectives of the study. These things must be there in all the proposal, either MD, MPH or PhD. Objectives of the study. List down at least 4 to 6 objectives that you want to study. Why you want to study? What are your focus? What you will be looking at? Which is your interest to know? That you need to put it into the objective. Purpose, again, objectives, purpose and importance are the similar things. For MD thesis, maybe you can put one. Or for MPH, maybe 1 or 2 aspects. But for PhD, you need to put separately all these objectives. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 objectives. Purpose, almost similar to the objectives, but it will be done as purpose. For example, you say that the objective of the study is to understand the present day mission work. Then you say the purpose. When you come to the purpose, then you say there are so many things that we need to understand related with the present day mission work, and therefore this study purposes to look at what are the areas. importance of the study, the same aspect, but you put it into another place. This is very important to understand this particular aspect of mission in the present day. Therefore, this study is focusing on the same. So based on each objective, you can write the purpose as well as importance of the study. Rationale, reason or rationale are similar things. The same thing, the reason for your study. PhD thesis must contain the reason, what has prompted you, what has made you study, that you need to write it detailing. The reasons, the you know, thoughts, the philosophy behind your work must be included. Method of research must be there in MD, MDH, and PhD. What is the method you are adopting? If you are a mission student, then missionary perspective. If you are a history student, historiography. If you are a New Testament student, critical tools related to New Testament, biblical studies. If you are a counseling student, theories related to the interpretations in counseling. All departments will have, or they have, their own methodologies, and you must follow those methods. Then look for scope and limitation. Know what study is final. We may have geographical limitations. We may have limitation of time, limitation of pages. So there are some limitations. We also have a scope. Limitation is also a scope. Suppose you are doing some study related to Kerala. You are doing something related to Middle East. That is your scope, as well as that is your limitation. Up to where you are going, that is your scope. Where do you limit? That is your stop. So you have to look at where you are moving and then put a mark related to it, boundary to it, that is scope and limitation. Every thesis must have a previous research and review of literature, especially for PhD. When you are doing a particular area of analysis, look for all the publications in the same area. You need to have the review of literature. For MDH, you must look for the previous works, at least 4 or 5 works. Review of literature for PhD can be one chapter. One chapter work will be related to all works that are published thus far related to that particular area. Suppose you are doing child theology. All the books published related to child theology must be incorporated in your review of literature in your PhD thesis. But in MDH, you can put maybe 4 or 5 books and say that your work at present is completely different from the previous work because of its title, scope and limitation, and your area of interest. Someday methodology. So your work must be different one step further to all the works thus far done. And you must have definition of key terms. If you are using any foreign words in your title, then you must explain it. Definition of key terms. Then you must give a chapter scheme. What you deal with, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, that you have to give. Then tentative outline. Chapter scheme will be in full sentence, but tentative outline will be in points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Under each chapter, what are the sub points that you can give it? Final proposal will have final outline. And then there must be bibliography in your proposal. Thank you. All right, so we stop there for discussion. That if you have some questions to be clarified, then we will take it up and then we'll move on to the second section.
Excuse me, ma'am. When we write something newspaper, when we related to our subject, what shall we give that? The title for that. We should have a title for that. Yeah.
For what our, you are writing from the.
For bibliography, what shall we write? Yeah.
You have to say which newspaper. India Today, comma, date of publication, day of publication, in which edition, from where, either it is Kottayam or Delhi or London. Which edition you are using. So we will come to bibliography. Already one section is there for bibliography. Okay. One or the two or the three or the commentary, dictionary, all those we will be.
Date of publication is needed?
date of publication as well as which place it is published. Which place?
Okay.
We have got cities: Malayalam Manorama. We have Trivandrum, Kollam, Alappuzha, Kottayam, Malappuram, etc. So which edition? It's not same news, you know. In each major content will be same, but depends on the district, we will have different news. So you need to put which edition.
Thank you, ma'am.
We will come. Ask me what we already discussed. Anything from what we have discussed.
Okay, ma'am. Excuse me, ma'am. Yeah, this is about research review of the books, review of literature. Let me write research proposal. You told that when you reading, a lot of reading is needed. And when you read one book, one page of summary, we take the abstract of it, whatever abstraction of that, we write it. But in the review of literature, how many books you expect for that review? Because there are lots. So research proposal, there should be a limit for that review of literature. So how do we come to that? Review of literature and reading, what is the difference?
Book review, that is completely different. Suppose for example, if you are doing some studies related with Paul, and there is one book normally given for the students to read, the first urban resistance, which has 360 pages. But the student will be asked to write maybe 3 pages of a book review. That is completely different. When it comes to thesis and to the previous research, your concern is that for doctoral students, for PhD, we can set even one chapter for review of literature, which means you will be writing nearly 30 pages.
Yes.
Minimum 30 pages. So these 30 pages, you can surely include 60 books. Each paragraph can be one book. Other name, the book title, major content.
Okay.
Why you give that major content? Because at the end of the chapter, you will come to say, I have discussed these 60 books, but none of these books equal to my writing that I'm going to write.
Okay.
And then in scope and indication, my work is different.
Okay.
To prove that we are writing.
Okay.
Now, suppose you are not doing in MDS level, you are not doing one chapter, but you are writing in the thesis proposal, maybe 2 pages. 2 pages you are covering at least maybe 4 books. So for example, sometimes you may write 6 to 8 books also. That also you are saying the title, author, and then the major content to come to a conclusion that your work is different than all the work that is done thus far.
Okay.
It's on the heaviness of your work.
And while writing this review of literature, we always mention whose book, which page, and this is what I have reviewed it, and I'm just reproducing it in the paper. So this comes in research proposal. Yes, ma'am? This comes in research proposal, review of literature.
Research proposal, you can limit it to maybe 4 or 5 book names.
Okay.
And one sentence.
So while writing review of literature itself, we are mentioning, then also we need a bibliography towards the end, the same thing to be repeated?
Sure.
Sure, okay.
Because while writing, you may give it in the footnote.
Yeah.
In the content, you will write author name, book name only.
Correct.
Then in footnote, you will write full. But in bibliography, the same footnote is copied to convert to bibliography.
Okay.
So it's necessary.
Okay. Next question is about, what do you mean by method of research? What is the difference between method of research and research methodology, research tool? These three terms, I'm slightly confused.
This we are saying. Okay. But another thing, source of the study.
Okay.
Sometimes students confusion between method and source. Method and source. You say method of study, methodology, tool, these three things are same.
Okay.
Research methodology is what the method of research.
Okay.
That's methodology.
Means that is innumerable, no madam. Whatever topic we are doing, it can be very different from what others do also. Yes, the samples we choose and how do we execute that particular research can be very different for us also, right?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Now,
research
methodology, for each department, we have different methodology.
Okay.
For example, biblical studies, we call it as critical tools, false criticism, form criticism, redaction criticism, literary criticism, narrative criticism, sociological reading, feminist reading, liberal reading, etc. Some of these things are taken in other departments. For example, ecological reading is adopted both in missional reading as well as in the theology.
Okay.
Or you look at that, some methodologies, historical criticism in history, in the biblical studies, in mission, all these we look at historiography.
Okay.
In counseling, we have some of the methodologies, either personality traits or theories related with the counseling, that we take it. There also you can use it, maybe some of the theories related to Sigmund Freud, his own theory in different levels, psychopathology or different things. There are theories like that. So you can use any one methodology, only one methodology for your case work. Or sometimes we use combining the methodology, two methods together or three methods together. We use the critical tool to study that particular area. So depends on department. Depends on your area specialization, one of the critical methodology will be adopted. Now, source of study is the source that we have two. One is the primary source, second is the secondary source. Primary source are like interviews or the original work of that particular person. For example, you are studying about M.M. Thoma. Then his writing, autobiographical writings are the primary source.
Okay.
His letters are the primary source. Then we have the secondary source, people wrote related to him, and then based on him, something developed. So that is secondary source. Then we say it is the research that is based on library. Library books are adopted. For counseling, we say empirical studies. That is questionnaire prepared and given outside for filling it. That is empirical studies. Qualitative, quantitative studies. That is different. So these are words used but with a different understanding. Methodology understood, quantitative understood, social study understood, and then research related.
Yeah. And in the literature review, suppose we do a biblical topic. Can we see it is something related with errors and its analysis and all? That's my topic. So when I look into devotional books, I can even look into general books, right? Literature review.
Academic work must be always from the academic level, no devotional book.
Okay.
But I said when you read itself, when you write, either it is for academic level or it is for lay people, or it is for the outsider to whom we are focusing. Academic work is purely academic.
Okay.
So if it's related with the and then you say my standing is this and I would like to work related to this particular area.
Now about definition of keywords, you said definition of the words which we use. The definition can be very different from our point of view also we can define. Is that right, madam?
I have to say what you define with that term that you use in your work.
Okay.
You are,
So our point of view, our definition also can be there.
Okay. There may be the option of definition, but I view it, not, for example, I view kingdom value. For me, that is the value, that is the moralities by these enter into God's kingdom.
Okay.
So things like that, you can develop your own creativity in making your definition. And you can also depend in books. Suppose you agree with one of the definitions. Somebody said, what is worship? Worship is inward, outward expression of inward attitude. You can say, I believe in it. That is what I meant here.
Oh. Madam, one page means how many words?
Mm-hmm. That is a good question.
More or less.
It may be 300 to 500 words.
Okay.
300 to 500 words. When I say 300, depends on the footnote. You know, sometimes you may have the writing. I am a person who would put so much of footnotes. So my content will be less.
Mm-hmm.
And you may find, if you look at my writings, then you will see this as more footnote than the bibliography. So sometimes you will find the work like that. So
So including footnotes, it is 300 to 500, one page. You mean? No.
We will not calculate actually. Okay. Okay. That we will not be calculating. Okay. Otherwise, we calculate every word.
Okay.
Apart from the prepositions and definite articles.
Okay. Madam, I have more doubts, but someone can take a chance and then let me go through the writings of mine.
Also. Maybe they may have had the same questions in their mind.
I have more.
No worry.
Anybody how many else? Chapters for a PhD? How many chapters? Is there a range like minimum or maximum?
At least 4 to 6.
Okay.
Minimum must be 4. Minimum. Okay. For PhD, can go for 5 to 7 also, no problem, but not beyond 8.
Okay. And one chapter, how many pages?
I will say introduction, conclusion, no chapter number.
Okay.
Chapter begins after introduction. Normally, introduction is the thesis. And then we begin chapter 1.
Okay.
And remember, this rule is followed for MD, MPH, PhD. Your major chapter must contain more than half of the pages expected. For example, your thesis, PhD thesis, number of pages 300. So your major chapter should be 150 pages.
Okay.
It may be the third or fourth chapter.
Okay.
That chapter must be 150 pages. Now balance you have 150 pages. So divide that 150 equal balance before or after the major chapter.
Okay.
Suppose your major chapter is 4. So you have 2 chapters before the 4th chapter and 2 chapters after the 4th chapter. So what you will do? 75 pages for the first section, 75 pages for the second section. Okay. 5 pages will go for, maybe 20-20 you can put it. And then leave it for conclusion also the page number. Introduction, you have to set the page number. So maybe you will have 10 pages of introduction, 10 pages of conclusion. 20 pages already gone. Then balance you have. Out of 150, you have 130 pages. So maybe you can put it 60 pages in one side, 65 pages on the other side, which means 30 pages for each chapter. Chapter 130 page, chapter 230 page, 150 for the middle section, and then 30, 30, 10. So all together, but the major focus, now MPH, 120 pages. Out of 120, 60 pages must be your main chapter. That is chapter 3 must be for you, 60 pages. Then balance your 60 pages. So we say out of 60 pages, 30 pages for the first section, 15, 15, or else 10 and 30. 10 pages for the first chapter, 10 pages for the second chapter, 60 pages for the middle chapter, that is third chapter. Then again, 20 pages for the fourth chapter, and then or third chapter, fourth, go on like that. Depends on. Okay, get me. The preliminary pages and bibliography will not be counted with the major content. Introduction to conclusion pages will be counted 1 to 300 or 1 to 10, 1 to 60 or 1 to 120.
Excuse me, ma'am, for PhD thesis, how many pages for introduction and how many pages for conclusion?
Maybe 5-5.
5-5, okay.
So, before conclusion, you may give the implication that can be 10 pages.
Okay.
Sorry, ma'am, for the MD student, how many pages you had to write for thesis?
Which one?
MD students for thesis, how many pages we had to write?
60.
And we have read 60 books, isn't it?
Minimum 60 books.
60 books. Okay, thanks.
Encourage them to use more books. Minimum you can say, but maximum never say.
Madam, the area of research, you said. I have written and I'm not getting, madam. You said something about area of research. Yes, ma'am? Area. you said, na, madam. Area in the sense job, you the topic wise or location wise, what do you mean by that, madam?
Topic. Not geographical area, okay. Not geographical. Purely your syllabus based.
Yeah.
Now, depends on number one area, which means your department study.
Okay.
Your New Testament or Old Testament, I don't know which are the branches you have and which are the branches you are involved to. Maybe theology, mission, history of Christianity, aftercare and counseling. There are other departments, many departments are there. So, number one is your department, that is area specialization. Number two, under that department, you have many. For example, history of Christianity, you have early Christianity, middle age, and then modern period. So, in that, this is your area of attraction. This is earliest Christianity that you like to do, or you like to do related with Reformation period or the modern period. Mission also same thing, or past care and company, as I said, depends on the age group. You say maybe up to age, or early adolescent, teenage, or youth, or you want to do related with married couple, etc. So that has an age. That has an age. Can be.
And if we mentioned about the sample to a particular, location-wise, suppose I am taking students from Mumbai, suppose I'm doing, but now since the whole scenario is changed, half the time I'm in Kerala and half the time in Mumbai, it's like that. So is it okay if I take two samples from and make a study of it? Because if it is possible.
You are in one place and you want to do study from other places, not a problem, but do not mix the geographical location.
Okay.
Because the experiences, attitude of people in each geographical space is different. Okay. So if you are concentrating on children in Mumbai, you when you go there, collect data and then come back and do your work.
Okay.
But mix in between these two. Okay. Otherwise, you should be a comparative study. Suppose you are doing comparative study.
Okay.
You want to between the children here and children there, do it. You can do two analysis. No problem.
Okay.
If your focus is Mumbai, then that's your geographical location.
Suppose I'm not mentioning about the comparative study in the title or in the proposal, but when in the process it is happening, can I do that way? A slight change in the... No, I can't.
Something must be changed. No. From the hypothesis, it must be changed. Otherwise, you are not true to the work.
Okay.
So once you're true to the work, then you say, I have involved these two. I have included these. No matter.
Okay.
Just adding to the work when you complete it.
Okay.
You feel the need. Suppose, as you work on, you feel the need of making a comparison. Okay. And add those things in the appendix. Separate questionnaire for these children here. Okay.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. Any other? Anybody?
Sorry, ma'am, one more question. Is there any restriction or limitation to choose the subject?
Depends on our passion, our desire. But it must be related with our area. Suppose your department, which branch you have taken, tell me. MD is for free. You can take from any subject. You can take biblical studies, you can take theology, you can take counseling, you can take mission, you can take any topic, no matter. You are free to choose. But once in MTS, then your area of specialization. If it is New Testament, Old Testament, theology, history, your department. But only you have freedom to choose whatever is your passion. What you like to do, then do it, no problem.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, anybody else?
Ma'am, for MTS thesis, statement of the problem should be in one page or one paragraph, you said?
MTH statement must be
half page.
Maximum one paragraph.
One paragraph. Okay.
For MD, MTH same. Even for doctorate, statement of the problem can be one paragraph. Elaboration can be different.
Okay.
For MD, it can be one page. For MTH, two pages. For PhD, it can be four pages. Elaboration of the problem. Because In PhD, you can even use an example. What you are going to do, that example, you can put it in the elaboration of the problem. So you get 4 pages in PhD.
Madam, total research proposal, how many pages? Whole proposal.
It can be 10 to 15 pages.
Okay. Proposal.
Yeah. For MD, it can be 8 to 10 pages. For MD, it can be 5 to 7 pages. Anything else?
I think, ma'am, you have covered everything, I think so.
Yes. I can move on, right? Second section. Section B.
How many pages for this in MGH?
120,
okay.
120.
Okay. Is there...
So here I have only half an hour more. So I would like to move on related with the major focus, that is nature of the research, you know, is researching. Types of research depends on qualitative, quantitative, empirical study. Developing research strategy, that is also depending on us, area, which place, all those things we deal with. Writing skills, grammar, punctuation, those things. Citations, I would like to talk a little bit because plagiarism also related to the citation. Then layout of research report, that is depending on maybe once you complete your work to some level, you can request the college to ask me to meet you once again so that I'll tell you how to put the thesis in its correct layout. A4 size sheet. If you want to note, you can note it, but I don't know whether you will forget or not. It must be A4. When you choose from the computer, you have to choose for A4 size. 1.5 on the left side, 1.5 inch for the top, and right side and bottom, 1 inch. Once again. Left and top 1.5 inches, right and bottom 1 inch. In the major content page, you have to give footnote in the bottom. Font size should be Times New Roman 12. Font size. Times New Roman 12. Never use a font bigger than that. Even for the chapter title. Chapter title can be bold. Chapter title can be bold, capital letter. But font size always should be 12. Even in your other work, all the works that you do, it must be font number 12. Times New Roman is the font. Normal pages, you put the page number in the bottom. First page of the chapter will not have the page number. These are common thing. Maybe ask your guide, correct your thesis, you can see those things. Okay. I don't want to take much time here. Nature of research, that is a good paper, needs to be well researched. That is well written, well researched, well presented. It is research. Search is an intellectual activity, so we are researching into topic that we are dealing with. Then there are different types of research like qualitative, observation, participant observation, interviewing, focus group and case study. Qualitative and quantitative. That is in the form of quantitative data, we collect how many, to what degree. And in empirical research, same thing. We look at especially from the data collection. And then developing a research strategy, as we have already said, select a topic, narrow the topic, do primary researches, make auto summary, build writing, working bibliography, take note, evaluation sources, consulting draft, and then be writing, polishing the draft, preparing the final copy. When you deal with writing skill, look for style and grammar, correct punctuation, paragraph. This is important. I have seen sometimes students would put one page as one paragraph. Please do not exceed more than 6 to 8 lines for a paragraph. 6 to 8 lines for paragraph. Not more than 8 lines. 6 to 8 lines is the maximum for a paragraph. Basic unit of research paper is paragraph. And each paragraph, if you are a good writer, each paragraph must deal with one particular topic. The whole area that you are dealing in a section, each paragraph must be new. And then when you do theological English, we say this one, either first sentence of the paragraph, middle sentence of the paragraph, or the last sentence of the paragraph will be the topic sentence, TS, topic sentence. So first sentence, middle or last. One sentence must be the paragraph, must summarize the paragraph. Either it can be, this is how in any English writing you will find. Any writing that you read, you will find there is a topic sentence. Topic sentence can be either in the beginning, middle, or at the end. Okay, that topic sentence must be maintained. Then explanation and discussion must be in that paragraph. So this writing style is also important. Do not write the same thing repeated in all the paragraph all the time, because that may be predominating, yes, and then we keep on write the same thing in all the paragraph. That should not be. Then the most important thing is citation. So many things to say related with quotation, direct quotation, block quotation, summarizing, paraphrasing. These are the ways of citation. Listen, quotations necessary in all the writing. Indirect quotation, normally we use paraphrased or summarized without quotation mark. Direct quotation that we are using, verbatim that we are using, every time put the double inverted comma for the quotation. Listen very, very carefully. Do not cite directly more than 3 lines. When you quote, you can quote only 3 lines. In quotation mark, you can put only 3 lines of quotation. Then you can use block quotation. Block quotation, which means inside the margin, 5 space in both sides, and then you place the text in the middle with 10 font size. I repeat this thing. Normal thesis will have 12 font in double line space. Normal thesis pages, 12 font in double line space. In the block quotation, 10 is the font size, single line, 5 space indented. That is only in the middle. That is known as block quotation. If it is more than 3 lines, then you have to give block quotation. I don't know. You can see it. See here. This is normal paragraph. But here, 5 space indented from both the sides. That is block quotation. Block quotation. In between the writing, you can have block quotation if it is more than 3 lines. That time you don't need to put double inverted comma, but it is pressed inside. Pressed inside. Direct quotation, only 3 lines. 3 lines with double inverted comma. And you must give footnote after giving double inverted comma. You can't leave it. When there is double inverted comma, there must be footnote. Footnote numbering should be there. It can be one word, it can be two words, it can be one line, it can be one sentence, it can be maximum 3 lines. Not 3 sentences, 3 lines. Maximum 3 lines for direct quotation. Then you can do paraphrasing. You can do summary. Read it. At least change one word in the sentence and write it as your own. Maybe grammar. You can change is into was. No problem. But there must be at least one change in a sentence that you are putting a summary or indirect quotation. Indirect quotation. In the indirect quotation, every three ideas must be footnoted. When you take somebody's idea, one, two, three, maximum three. One idea you have to give footnote, two ideas you have to give footnote, maximum three ideas. More than that, you cannot do it. If it is together. You can do summarizing. Read a paragraph, understand it, put it as your own. This paraphrasing is an art actually. Making it as your own. Read something and then make it as your own is an art. You cannot easily do it, but practice it and you can do it. Practice it, you can do it. Paraphrasing. And then the most important thing is plagiarism. Plagiarism referring related to the act of copying, duplicating the idea or concept, word, statement that somebody which is illegal. If your thesis is not original, you have taken it from the internet, a reader like me will easily find it because there are software. There are plagiarism checker software that you can use it and see how many sentences you have copied from internet, copied from any book, or is this work done by somebody else available in the online? Many diseases were rejected like that. So be very, very careful to not to copy from anywhere. Never do plagiarism, but just make your own work, original work. Copy this stuff. Clear to you those things. I just want to take you at another place. So there must be some significant aspect that you have to look at. The layout of the research paper, there are preliminary pages, title page, acknowledgements, declarations, list of figures, tables, abstracts, all these things. This is what I said once. You are ready with your thesis, then maybe we can take it up once again. Table of content, main text. All these things must be there. Beginning, these are preliminary pages that you have said just now, but the main chapter division, introduction, then introducing the topic, chapter one, chapter two, chapter three. These are, you know, the main structure of the thesis. First chapter will be introduction. Second will be review related literature, design or methodology of research, analysis and interpretation of data. Fifth one will be conclusion. So, but it can be one or two chapters in between. The main chapter will be elaborated and then there will be other divisions within the chapter. The main body of the work, the chronological comparison, effect, analysis, all these things will be there. And I said earlier, style and grammar, punctuation, paragraphing, topic sentence, explanation, all these are part of it. So you may have to look at those things. And then one more thing that I would like to just take it hurriedly. Footnoting and bibliography. So when you do footnote, that is citing the work, you have to give correct citation. In the footnoting, the first line must be five space indented. First line, five space indented in the footnote. Five space indented in the footnote. In the bibliography, second line will be hanging. Only in the first, it comes from the front and then it is hanging. That choice you can make it actually. If there is time at the end, I'll show you those things. Let me just go with these things because there is only less time. In the bibliography, you need to arrange it according to the alphabetical order. A to Z, you need to arrange it. Then the bibliographic collection is also significant. For example, you need to arrange bibliography in a definite order, same like in a library. When you enter into the library, in the first section, you have the encyclopedia. Those encyclopedias should be in the first category of the bibliography. Second section in the library, if you go, you find dictionaries in the second section. So dictionaries are the second material that you need to arrange in the bibliography. First is encyclopedia, second is dictionary. Third, biblical commentaries. If you are writing any biblical commentary, then if you are using any biblical commentary, then you must note it in the third stage commentary. Then the fourth section must be books. Fourth section must be books. And the fifth one, once you come out of the library section, then you find the journals. So journals in the next section. Then you can put the web bibliography. Bibliography can be at the end. Newspapers, all other things can be placed later on. Unpublished materials, diseases, all those things. So there is the order of putting it. And now the model, writing model for either a single author, two author and so on. Basic format for writing the basic footnote and bibliography, I say. The first one, to write, I think some of you already had some classes related with these things, research methodology, whether you had it or not, but you can just note down. Basic order in the footnote, first author name full as it is, author name, comma book name, author name, comma book name. Normally we finish with that and go on with bracket, place of publication, publication company. But suppose if this book is edited work, then you need to put it before bracket, author name, book name, then edited work, translated, series, first edition, second edition, or volume, number, anything that you have to put it, and then bracket, place, colon, publisher, comma, year, bracket close, comma, page number. I don't know how many of you got it. I repeat, full author name, comma, book name, bracket, place of publication, colon, publisher, comma, year, bracket close, comma, page number. In the bibliography, the second name of the author will be first. Second name of the author will be first. And then second name of the author, comma, the first name of the author, full stop, book name, full stop, no bracket, place of publication, comma, publication company, comma, place of publication, colon, publication company, comma, year, full stop, no page number. I repeat again, in the bibliography, second name of the author is first, comma, first name of the author, full stop, name of the book, full stop, place of publication, colon, publication company, comma, year, full stop. Name of the book always must be in italics. If there are two authors, in the footnote, first name of the author and the second name of the author, then normal, name of the book, then bracket, place of publication, colon, publication company, comma, year, bracket close, comma, page number. When it comes to the bibliography, only the first name of the author, the second part will be first. Rest everything is same as one author. If there is no author given, N-A, no author. No place of publication, NP. No name of the publication, NN. No page number, NP. Now, if I say all these things also, how much will stay in your mind, I do not know. But if you have some doubt, you can ask me. Then I'll explain each of these if it is necessary. Related with the entry of bibliography or related with the materials that you deal with.
Madam, this page numbers and all, I mean the bibliography part, it was a little too much to take it down. So do we get a copy of it, ma'am? Can you make arrangement for that?
Bibliography section, I will give.
Yes.
Very common, but yes. This part.
Thank you.
Because I have taken very hurriedly. I'm not right in saying everything that you can understand with the time. I will surely let it.
Can you explain me, ma'am, about that bibliography once more?
Normal bibliography. In the footnote, author name has to be, comma, book name, italic. In the bracket, place of publication, color, publication company, comma, year of publication, bracket close, comma, page number. When it comes to bibliography, the first name of the author will be second. For example, if it is my name, Jayashree KB, then KB, comma, Jayashree, full stop. Then the book name. One of my books that I say here, this is the title, the 500 Years of Reformation, or there is yet another book, Spirituality, or yet another book, Bible and Mission. So put the name of the book as it is, then put in no bracket. In the bibliography, only ask it is. Place of publication, color, company, then comma, page number. If it is, see, there are some, for example, dictionary, journal, and then encyclopedia, you have to give page number both for footnote as well as for the bibliography. Dictionary, encyclopedia, journal. Those things you have to give. Journal also will include magazines or newspapers, all those things that you have to give the page number in the bibliography also. But those things, other book, like book, articles in a book, edited work, in all those things, there is no page number given in the bibliography. The footnote, you have to give the exact page number, which page from where you have cited that you have to give. Any other thing?
Madam, this block quotation, what is the spacing to be given as margin?
Five space. Single line.
Okay.
Other than normal cases, two line space for the text. But in the block quotation, it will be single line. So we can differentiate. Then the font number should be 10. Font size should be 10.
Madam, in case we need the consent from the author and they refuse to give the consent, what should we do?
Actually, in disease writing, we don't need anybody's permission because we are quoting their writing as it is. But if you're writing some works related to one person, you want to do some analysis related to one of my findings, then you need to get the permission. If you are not getting permission, you have to cancel the project.
You mean don't need the consent from the author to write their quote in the thesis?
You don't need to get permission.
No. Yeah.
You quote it, give the footnote. That is What if anything you've got to give the footnote? Nobody can come and claim anything.
It's not affecting the plagiarism.
You don't need to get their permission.
No, then I mean, it's not affecting the plagiarism.
We don't need it. We need permission. The map. Suppose there are some statistics. As it is, we are copying. If you are copying those things, then we need their permission. Some original photographs, they might have gone to some libraries and taken some photos. Those pages, it will be given. Do not use it without prior permission. If that is stated, then we are copying as it is. We are using in our thesis that way, then we need their, permission. Otherwise, we don't need to. Only in such a case, where it is definitely said that you need the permission. Otherwise, the direct statements and all, we don't need their permission. We are using putnam, so we don't need their permission.
Thanks.
If you publish it, you need their permission. Suppose you are taking my article as a fault, and then you are publishing it in your work, in your book, that you want to publish it without my permission, you can't do it. Citations, you can do it. But the full article that I've written, suppose you may find one of my articles here in this book that you will find, Philanthropic Mission of Jesus. But you are taking that particular article and putting it in another book without my permission is not accepted. That you need to get a prior permission.
So you mean the future? So you mean the future, if I'm planning to publish this thesis as a book, you know, so we need to get the consent from the author, you mean that?
No. Your work is original. Your work is original. You have cited everything that you copied from anybody else. If you are confident enough, publish it. If you have taken, suppose, one article of mine as it is and written in your thesis without my permission, then there will be a problem. I will file case second.
All right, I got it. Thanks.
That's the rule. That's right. But for citations we have given, then you must have original work and it must be published. And any of you have your thesis ready, once it is publishable, if you need any help related to publishing your work, please let me know. There are publications willing to publish your work, original work, freely. And if you are writing good articles, if you want to publish your articles, if you are interested to present your articles, that also you can ask to get my number and then you can send me those things, we can publish it. Either in journals or in books, we can present it in national colloquiums. If you are qualified enough to present some papers, you will always get an opportunity. Okay, I hope there is no other questions.
No, ma'am, suppose we have a specific doubt to ask you. Can we interact with you? Not very often, at least sometime.
Sure, you can.
Yeah. Okay. How do we, through email or WhatsApp? What? How? Which channel?
WhatsApp for me.
WhatsApp is good. Okay.
WhatsApp, you can get my number from them. And then, if they permit you to just contact me, surely I will. Oh. And there is time permits. Maybe once you are ready with some stages of your work, when the proposal is ready or your titles are ready, you need some consultation, surely I will be available.
Okay.
And then I will also do electronic readings if you have your. Chapter ready for you to read, someone to read it, I'll help it in that way.
Okay.
All right, hope nothing more. 2 more minutes left for us.
Sorry, but one more question. Do you accept this thesis as the handwriting or you need the computer writing?
Yes, I need it in printed form or else in the soft copy, not in handwritten. Because even if we correct everything in handwritten, once they come in the typed form, it will be completely different. So it must be typed. You can write it, edit it, type it, then send it to the reader. Never give the handwritten copy because many errors will come while typing, like full stop, comma, punctuation, that we can look at it only once it is final. Try to give the final draft to the guide to read. That will be easy for the guide. Then giving every time pressure to them, or you ask them to read 2-3 times. Don't do it. Give someone who knows English, give outside to read, let them read, correct it, and give the final draft for the your guide to read, so that they will not reduce the mark. Otherwise, they will reduce mark for methodology. So try your level best. When we are putting mark, if it is empty also, we have reached 6 points are there. Like some of you might have gone for ask judges in Sunday school or challenges, and you know how we give mark. The same way we give mark for the thesis work also. For the methodology, thought pattern, punctuation, ideas, the flow of ideas, thought, and then the structure of the work, conclusion, bibliography, all those things we give mark. So arrange it in a way as the perfect draft you give to the reader or your guide, so that it will not be a burden for them.
Either English or Malayalam, so.
I think all of you are doing it in English, right?
So actually, we are doing the MD Malayalam.
Okay. That also, please type it and give it in the final draft. Say the Malayalam or English, no matter. But you have to give it in the final draft. Type the one. Right.
Thank you.
And when you are doing it in Malayalam, use the English book, use your translation. You can do your own translation, but give the same English book for citation. We can do. All right. I think it's time for us to stop. Hope there is nothing left to say for now.
Thank you, ma'am, for this wonderful session. A lot of learning.
I have a few books. One is Basic Methodological Study Aid, and yet another one, 100 Dream Abrams book, which I will share to Gemma sister, and she may share with you. 100 Dream Abrams Research Methodology. I can share that book, and then you will get a chance to look at it. This is the book, Manual for Researchers and Writers. You get the basic understanding from here, not everything that we have discussed, but some of those things. This is one of the standard texts that we follow, but it has its own problem. It could not be bibliography and text, not other things. But illustration, materials, tables, all those things, it's very clear. So I'll give this material for you for the further reference. How to prepare book reviews, report, everything is given there. So it will be helpful. Okay. I'll share it today. So there is nothing more. We can start with a word of prayer. One of you can lead us into it. We can do this. You want to pray? Any of you?
കർത്താവെ, നന്ദിയോടെ അങ്ങയെ സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു, നന്ദിയോടെ സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു. ഞങ്ങളെ വാത്സല്യമായി സ്നേഹിക്കുന്ന ഞങ്ങളെ സ്വർഗീയ നല്ല കർത്താവെ, വൈകാര സമയത്ത് കോളേജ് കർത്താവെ, ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഒരുമിച്ച് ഈ പ്ലാറ്റ്ഫോമിലായിരിക്കും ദൈവം സഹായിച്ചു. കർത്താവെ, ദാസെ ഭവിഷ്യതമായ കാര്യങ്ങളെ പഠിപ്പിക്കാൻ തക്കൊണ്ട് ദൈവശക്തമായി ഉപയോഗിച്ചു. കർത്താവ്, ഞങ്ങൾ കേട്ട കാര്യങ്ങൾ ഞങ്ങൾ ഭാവിക്ക് അത് ഉപകരിപ്പാൻ തക്കൊണ്ട് ദൈവം സഹായിക്കണമെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. എല്ലാ പഠിതാക്കളുടെ കരങ്ങളെ കേൾപ്പിച്ചു പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുകയാണ്. ശലോമോൻ മേൽ പകർന്ന പോലെ വിശേഷ അജ്ഞാനത്താൽ എല്ലാവരും നിറയ്ക്കണമെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. കർത്താവ്, കർത്താവ്, ഇതിനാവശ്യമായി ഞാനും വിവേകതയും കൊടുത്തിട്ട് ദൈവരാജ്യത്തിന് കെട്ടുപണിക്ക് വേണ്ടി എല്ലാവരും ഉപയോഗിക്കുന്നതിനായി സ്തോത്രം. കർത്താവ്, ഞങ്ങളിൽ നല്ല പ്രവൃത്തി ആരംഭിച്ചവന് ക്രിസ്തേശുവിന്റെ നാളോളം തികപ്പാൻ ശക്തനെന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ പൂർണ്ണമായി ഉറപ്പിക്കുന്നു. കർത്താവ്, ഇച്ഛിക്കുന്നവരാരും ആരുമല്ല, ഓടുന്നവൻ ആരുമല്ല, കരുണ തോന്നുന്നു ദൈവതാരത്തിലെ സകല സാധ്യമെന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ വായിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവ്. ആകയാൽ കർത്താവേ, വിശേഷ ജ്ഞാനം കൊണ്ട് വിവേകം കൊണ്ട് എല്ലാവരും നിറച്ച് അങ്ങയുടെ നാമത്തിന് വേണ്ടി സൽപ്രവൃത്തിക്ക് വേണ്ടി കർത്താവ് കൃത്യമുള്ള പ്രവാഹി തീർക്കണമെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. ഉറപ്പുള്ളവരാക്കി കുടുങ്ങാത്തവരാക്കി ക്രിസ്തേശുവിൻ ഞങ്ങളുടെ പ്രയത്നം വൃഥാവല്ല നിറഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ട് കർത്താവിന് വേറെ പ്രിയപ്പെടുവാം. ദൈവം എല്ലാവരെയും സഹായിക്കണമെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. കർത്താവ് ഞങ്ങളുടെ പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടവരുടെ നാവുകളെ സമർത്ഥരായ ലേഖന എഴുത്തുകൾ പോലെ ഉപയോഗിക്കണമേ. കർത്താവ് യുദ്ധത്തിനായ കൈകളെ പോരിനാൽ വീരലുകളെയും അഭ്യസിപ്പിക്കുന്ന നല്ല കർത്താവ് നിന്റെ കർത്താവ് പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടവരുടെ ഞങ്ങളുടെ കർത്താവ് പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടവരായ എല്ലാവരുടെ കരങ്ങളോട് കൂടിക്കണമെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുകയാണ്. അവർക്ക് ആവശ്യമായ എല്ലാ സോഴ്സുകളെയും ദൈവം കൊടുക്കണമെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. വിശേഷാൽ കോളേജിനെ ഓർത്ത് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. കർത്താവിന്റെ പിന്നിൽ പ്രവർത്തിക്കുന്ന എല്ലാ പ്രിയപ്പെട്ട വിശേഷാലയ സാറിനെ ഓർത്ത് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. അധ്യാപകരെ ഓർത്ത് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. എല്ലാവരും ദൈവം സഹായിക്കണമെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുകയാണ്. എത്രത്തോളം ഞങ്ങളുടെ കൂടെ കർത്താവ് തുടർന്ന് ഞങ്ങളോട് കൂടെ ഇരിക്കണമെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുകയാണ്. തിരുവരങ്ങളെ ഞങ്ങളെ സമ്പൂർണ്ണമായി താഴ്ത്തിയേൽപ്പിക്കുന്നു. യേശു മൂലം പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കണം ഞങ്ങളുടെ നല്ല കർത്താവേ. ആമേൻ.
താങ്ക് യു,
താങ്ക് യു മാം.